graph. Every zero parallel graph has two vertices. One is the source and the other is tail. Two distinct vertices. And you this is a you can leave maybe this. And you parallel connected the two. Maybe you have you want to parallel connect it, yes? And you get this one. And this is the distinct vertices here. And you want to serial connect it, maybe something like that. If you want to serial connect it, this one, you can just put this one up and put this one down. No matter what you want. The crucial part is if we have more, 1, 2, 3, 4, then the order changes. You don't know which order it is. So you have A, B, C, D. You can, if you want parallel connected, serial connected, it can be A, C, D, E. The graph is not unique. Three persons work together, no matter which order it is. Okay? And why? And Professor Wu asked me, what's the relation of this one and this one? This is you may have some background in double E. You need some background to realize this equation. E and C and C or D. A or D. Every green circuit should be like this, right? So to realize this green circuit, he must use, well, I don't know, no pen. To realize this, you realize this circuit, this is one and the other is the dual. The other is the dual, right? They're dual to each other. It's a CMOS technology. CMOS technology. They must be dual. And this is I try to explain this more. This is a material called polysilicon. This is another material called diffusion. Once you cross it, once a diffusion cross polysilicon is a transistor. Okay, so transistor you cannot connect two transistors too close, unless they are of the same thing. Right? What do you mean same thing? Is for example. So. Here, this is a very this two is material called this metal. Metal, you throw the input here. So this is this input. Then this one is the output. The output of E is equal to the input of A. The output of E is equal to the input of A. Okay? So you can connect, you can touch to each other. Otherwise you must be separate. Okay? Otherwise you must separate. So so this one EAB, then EAB is here, this vertices, here, this point. So CD must be separate. Okay? So you see A B E C D, everything is clear, right? And A B E C D. So the layout, why the reason the layout? At least I cannot say definitely the layout is smaller, but at least the width is smaller. There's no separation here. So let's move to. So any question about the first chapter? The reason I don't want to do the DCT problem, I think this can be done. This problem can be done. It's a should be dynamic program. No reason. Why? There's no reason why an order and the minimal number of tracks should be solved. I don't know, but it takes me at least 4 years to publish a paper, so I don't want to serve that test. So, this, now the second chapter is on Hamiltonian cycle. As I told you before, I write a book. The book is Studying Mathematics with Finger. It's quite reasonable. Both the Euler graph and the Hamiltonian cycle can be studied teaching something only with fingers. I don't know. Coloring is maybe a little bit difficult. If you want to do this in iPhone, maybe. Yeah. So, and I try to minimize the reader, the audience, the reader of the book. So maybe as young as possible, try. But as you can see, the first chapter, you only need to know what is even and what is odd. So I think it's quite reasonable. Right? It's quite reasonable. And the material of math should be changed reasonably with the aid of computer, you know. But what is what the material we should talk to the student? It's interesting. So here is the, you know, the story of Hamiltonian cycle. Hamilton really designed the problem to travel around the world. So you can design the problem of here is the problem and the solution. I think Hamilton think the problem is too easy to create this problem. So he required the problem, he required to assign any four paths and try to continue the path into a Hamiltonian cycle. I don't know, maybe Mr. Hamilton is too rich. I think he's a rich man. Right? He sell his royalty by $50, $15, I think. I don't know. But so here I introduce more about Hamilton problem. This one arrange the light tool on a chessboard. I think Euler has also done this problem before. And can this one find a Hamiltonian cycle? Can you find a Hamiltonian cycle for this graph? Well, try, and you will say definitely no. I tried to ask the young man why, and the young man was it's very challenging until they told me that here is they have a 13 red vertices and 12 yellow vertices. They are that's the reason why you cannot find a Hamiltonian cycle, because just counting every you begin with a yellow and red, it must be of the same size. So it's easy, right? You have already have a thing, it must be of the same size. Okay? And it must be even, so. And there's another thing. Well, once you delete the 12 vertices, here, you will get a 13 component. It is impossible. You cannot delete to delete S component to get more than S component. So this is another. So with this one, you can see, for example, this one is not Hamilton, because you delete these two vertices, you get three components. So this graph is not Hamiltonian. Okay. So there's another puzzle. You cover the chessboard with the wall, with the dominoes. No problem. Cover very well. And we have a defected dominoes, and I give my kid 31 dominoes, ask him to cover it. That we know, because these two vertices are of the same color, each domino will be covered one yellow, one white. So that's the reason why I think the young people can accept that. Okay. So ask them, how about the story about the different color? Can it be done? Well, I think this problem is easy once it's done. But if the problem is, say, any pair of vertices are deleted, can it always achievable to find to cover it? Well, for this problem, you know, they have 32 yellow and 32 white, so they are in total 1,000, more than 1,000 problems. How can you write a result in 1,000 problems in your answer sheet? It's totally impossible. It's a challenge work, but the answer is first you find the Hamiltonian cycle. Find the Hamiltonian cycle. Then you separate, you defect it, broken the chessboard. Then the chessboard is broken into two pieces. I think you got the idea. And I think the two pieces is of length two of even length. They are definitely two even length. So you can cover it without any problem. So I hope the young people can know of any or all how to prove it. So. I introduce one more problem is here is king and their ghost. The king wants to protect his people from the devil. He asked them to protect each other, to pray together one with another every day. Yeah. Well, I am a Christian. I play with my wife every day, but sometimes I say I'm tired. You play, I sleep. okay. The difficulty and maybe I can talk with Professor Wu, but since I love my wife very much, so I cannot communicate with Professor Wu. But so they challenge. The king find another solution. Sunday Monday Monday and Tuesday they play together, and Thursday Wednesday play together. Wednesday Saturday they play together, and Sunday they go to church every day every week. So that's the solution. So I asked the student, try to solve it again. It's a really challenging problem. How to solve it? So this is the solution. Find the Hamiltonian cycle first. Find the Hamiltonian cycle first. This is a cubic graph. In my book, I only care about cubic graph. Why? There's not that. The only reason is cube is really complicated enough, and you make more edges than difficult, too difficult for him. But cubic graph, there's a good news is a graph is cubic, then the number of vertices is even. So what's the good things about even? You can pair it up. Okay, so. So this one is Monday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, and the red is Thursday, Wednesday, and the uncolored should be Friday and Saturday. Okay. So finding our Hamiltonian cycle is interesting.
How to find the Hamiltonian cycle? You can find the book. Find a book to tell you how to find it. But I think this rule is nothing but heuristic, but no rule. Something like that. Suppose there is a vertex of degree 2, then Hamiltonian must include these two. These two A instead of these two X. One cannot return to the origin vertex before passing through the vertex of the graph. Suppose you have already traversed a vertex X, then all edges instant to X should be can be deleted. Okay. So you using this one, you may follow the rule, then you find the Hamiltonian cycle. So how about to find the Hamiltonian cycle for this one? And okay, it's easy, right? And this one, and this one, and even this one is larger and larger. But I try to teach the students, the kids, mathematical induction. You can find the solution here, then open it. Find larger and larger and larger, so it's easy. So let's try to find out try to find the this one is not Hamiltonian. So it seems not Hamiltonian. Then you will see the difficult. You try to find the Hamiltonian cycle, you will be like something like that. Try this way, and write down. Then, okay, then you write down. Suppose I give you a graph with 100 per vertices, and I want to ask you to prove it. It is not Hamiltonian. You don't want to do it anymore, right? Too tedious. So, I think the problem of to prove a graph is not Hamiltonian. I just want to say, to prove a graph is not Hamiltonian, it's even harder than it is Hamiltonian. Am I right? To prove a graph is not Hamiltonian is even harder. So I never say some bad word to my student. You can never achieve anything. It is ridiculous. You cannot say that. Right? Okay, so non-Hamiltonian is called NP. Co-NP is, once you know NP, maybe or NP complete is hard. So you don't want to, it's another problem you don't want to do. And however, it's co-NP even worse. So I just show you these two graphs are non-Hamiltonian. If you want to try to, random bound, try everything possible to show this one is not Hamiltonian. So we need some tool. We have already introduced two tools. Really, I already told you two tools to prove non-Hamiltonian. Here's one. Bipartite graph. It's not. It must be of even vertices. And this one delete s vertices. You cannot result in a graph with more than s components. There's another one. I think these two theorems. I think the student, young people, get it. So, however, I need one more. I must edit it because once I delete it, maybe I don't have anything to say. So I add one more. Greenberg condition. This I talk about loopless planar graph. Loopless. This graph is a planar graph, and the red one is a Hamiltonian cycle. red line is Hamiltonian cycle, and here is the sub-H is inside the Hamiltonian cycle, here is the sub-H outside the Hamiltonian cycle. Then you have four age phases and six age phases. There are many phases. I label it the number of phases in the Hamiltonian cycle, outside the Hamiltonian cycle. And then I introduce the concept of Greenberg condition. The Greenberg condition is very interesting to it's very useful to very useful to prove a non-Hamiltonian, a gram is not Hamiltonian. I must introduce it. And I try to I also prove it in the book, but I don't think it is not time to prove it here. So let's try. Try to prove this one is not Hamiltonian. Then it's easy, right? This one is not Hamiltonian because you have a lot of phases of phases five, and there is a phases of phases not. Then you will get the equation here. And the thing is, that means x9 should be congruent to 3. It's multiple of 3. However, it is not, right? Because there's only one basis of basis 9. So, there is a real application in computer science. The Hamiltonian cycle is useful in computer science. Why? You know, if you think about a computer network, and one computer say I'm going to use printer, and the other computer say I'm using a printer, I'm going to use a printer. So what is the result of the printer? The printer can be print the first one, or print the second one, or print both in the same time, or I don't know how to solve it. So how to solve it? The idea is very easy. The professor in computer science his idea from his children. The children sitting on a table and playing the game of hot potato. The hot potato may be handshake, passing around the side a circle, and the singing some sound, maybe happy birthday. And when the sound finished, the one who get the handkerchief need to sing the song in the middle, right? So then in the computer is they always passing the handkerchief in the ring, handkerchief in the row in the ring, and whoever get the handkerchief can print the computer, can use the printer. This is a famous computer. Maybe you know this is just the Kubernetes. You don't need to worry about what is hyperkin. There's nothing. That's just hyperkin in mathematical term. So the hypercube have a very famous compute Hamiltonian cycle. First one is 0, 1 and 0, 1, 1, 0. You copy it and take the dual, and the first one get 0 and the second one get 1, get 1. Then repeat it and reflect it, and the 0 and 1. Repeat. This is called gray code. They have a lot of applications in computer science. So this is called gray code. We can also discuss Hamiltonian cycle on directly graphs. This is a relation. The Hamiltonian cycle, the Hamiltonian cycle of the Dipolar sequence corresponding to the Eulerian circuit for this one. Okay, this is the only thing I know. The relation of Hamiltonian cycle and the Eulerian graph. So Hamiltonian cycle is incomplete. However, and as I told you before, non-Hamiltonian cycle is even harder. Okay, that's it. Next chapter, maybe. If that is too fast, I don't know. So I should work hard to add more material later. The students in Providence University, they are not really that smart, but they designed again some of the material.
Mr. No, one digit. Mr. No, you
want to find Hamiltonian path. No, because if you go with yellow vertex, and the second one is white vertex, yellow vertex, white vertex. So the 64 vertices should be white vertices, right? So definitely no. So you change the color, you change the different destination, you get the answer, right? So the problem is the mouse want to eat the cheese, and every cheese is, and then return back to the middle one. The answer is the middle one should be the of color white. It cannot be done. So how about this one? This is hypercube Q4. Can you find a Hamiltonian path from this one, this red, and to the blue one? Yes, but can you find the Hamiltonian cycle from the blue one to blue one? No. Okay, let's play the game again. Here is another Hamiltonian problem. You want to travel from here, Sydney, to Rome, your destination. This is beginning vertex, starting vertex, ending vertex. Can you do that? Well, how to show it is impossible. The idea is once you end with Rome, you take a plan back to Sydney. Take a plan back. Then apply the Greenberg condition. Apply the Greenberg condition. Then you solve the problem. So with this idea in mind, you want to find the Hamiltonian cycle from this one to this one. You just all you need to do is take a flight, and try to find the Hamiltonian cycle, and then delete the vertices. You get the corresponding answer for this one to this one. Okay? So. Here's a small town where I live. I and my son want to go home and eat all the good food. Then I need to find a Hamiltonian path. The next day, my wife and my daughter want to go home and to buy everything nearby. We need to find a Hamiltonian path. The puzzle, I don't know what this puzzle is, but recently they have this one. And all the students can study this. You know. I think you know. And no matter where I put the vertices here and the other destination, you try to have an answer. Already, they may know something, right? The problem is how can you draw this picture? I don't know. Yeah. So I mean, this one, no matter how you get, you can always get a solution. The problem is you always get the solution. Okay. So I mean, a Hamiltonian connected graph. Hamiltonian connected graph is, I introduced the concept of Hamiltonian connected graph. Is a Hamiltonian connected graph is there is a Hamiltonian path between any two vertices. Okay. So the proof, the result for the baby for the kid. Every Hamiltonian connected with more than three vertices, and with three or more vertices, is a Hamiltonian graph. How to prove it? The proof is easy. You take two neighboring vertices, and find the Hamiltonian path. Then headed, then you find the Hamiltonian cycle. It's easy. How do you teach how to know this fact? That's good. How? I don't know. Yeah. So please check this graph. It's Hamiltonian connected graph. Yeah. A lot of that you can ask them to play the game. A lot of questions. So try to construct a graph, a Hamiltonian connected graph with 10 vertices. Of course, you can use a complete graph with 10 vertices. However, too many edges. So you try to reduce it. Maybe this one. This one is every vertex of degree 3. Maybe this is the cheapest because they use the minimal number of ages. Here is the theorem is the degree of any vertex in a connected graph in a Hamiltonian Hamiltonian connected graph with four more vertices is of degree 3. Okay. This is Hamiltonian connected, I lost it. Should be at least okay. The proof is easy. How to prove it? This graph is there is a vertex of degree 2. And with these two vertices, can you find a Hamiltonian path from this one to this one? No, right? You can either go through X and you already get Z. Otherwise, you leave and you can never get X. It's an easy proof. So here is you can construct the Hamiltonian connected graph. This one is easy. And this one is odd number of vertices, but I only care about the even number of vertices because this one is not cubic graph. This one is cubic graph. So at least a lot of Hamiltonian connected graph. They are Hamiltonian connected graph. A question is maybe you can try to ask it. Draw a Hamiltonian connected graph. Try to create a Hamiltonian connected graph of your own and play. Can you play it? Create a Hamiltonian connected graph. There are Hamiltonian connected graph. I will call here all these graphs from here. From here to here, I call they are these graphs are category 1. I will use it later. I don't know what that property. There are a lot of property inside, but I call it category 1. And this one is Hamiltonian. This is bipartite graph. In bipartite graph, I cannot play. I can play the Hamiltonian cycle, a Hamiltonian path between any two vertices of different color. Okay. There are a lot of Hamiltonian laceable graph. Program. So, Any question about this part? So if you, too early, but I already. Any question? No. No. Then maybe I introduce one more chapter. Just a just a guideline. So here, this is Peter Pan and a crocodile. The next chapter, I will talk about the game like this. Peter Pan want to patrol all the cities in Neverland. Neverland, right? And you can ask him. However, the crocodile can be anywhere, any ages. So, what I try to tell you, I'm talking about. I'm trying to, as I told you, this one is a computer network. The crocodile is a broken age. Broken age can be occur any place. So I'm just talking about one age for tolerant Hamiltonian. I told you before, Hamiltonian cycle is important because you need computer cycle to control your printer, right? So I'm talking about this one. Then maybe tomorrow, I think this is enough for me. Here, you saw little red hat and a wolf. The baby know what I'm talking about. The baby know, the kid know what I'm talking about. And then he find his answer. There, no problem. I think he can find it if the drawing is easy. But I really tell him that a four tolerant, a vertex four Hamiltonian. Okay? Am I right? So maybe tomorrow I talk about this part. I think that's just the introduce here, up to here. Okay? Thank you.